Experiencing a trauma like that affects different people differently. How do you think it affected you personally?
Well, my life was never the same. You know, suddenly all my pals were missing, and I'm playing in a team that was full of enthusiasm and had the whole world at their feet. Suddenly, you have to come back, and the club was struggling to actually survive, even in the first division. And it was important time. It was a very traumatic time for the club. For me personally, I think from being a reserve who occasionally got a game in the first team, suddenly I was one that was in the first team on a regular basis, and I was in a position of responsibility that I had to take. So it did affect me a lot. It changed my whole attitude. I probably got into the first team. I probably got into the national team earlier than I would have ever have done if it not been for the Munich air crash. But I got into the first team really in the month before the accident, but I didn't expect to be there forever. I thought this was just a period when I would get the opportunity to play, but I would have to go back eventually into the reserves. But once the accident happened, suddenly I was in the first team all the time, and changed my life completely, really.
How difficult was it returning to Belgrade? I think it was a month later, wasn't it, with the England team? That must have been quite a tough experience.
Well, we were coming back from Yugoslavia when the accident happened. It was difficult because we had to fly, but I made the decision, you know, that you couldn't do anything other than fly. You know, it was impossible to go to places that you wanted to go to if you didn't use an aeroplane. But I was helped by lots and lots of people to settle in afterwards, and I was given lots of counselling by various people, and I think I handled it all right, really. I got away with it. But playing for England at that particular time was not the way I intended to play for England. I intended to play for England, hopefully one day, you know, with Duncan Edwards and Roger Byrne and Tommy Taylor. Unfortunately, it couldn't be.